Dear students, greetings of the day. I hope you all are healthy, staying safe, and keeping good care of your health. As we all are very well aware about that the widespread of COVID-19 virus is there in and around the world. And we all are staying at home just to protect and prevent ourselves first, then family, then society. In such a situation, we thought that this is good time to develop our skill as well as capability with the help of IT-enabled services, as we all have experienced and experiencing as well that now reaching to the mass with the help of IT-enabled services is very easy. So we also plan to reach you with the help of video lectures to deliver you some content related to the current semester. So before going to course detail, once again, I would like to introduce myself. I am Mayank Kumar Pandey, Assistant Professor in the Department of Management. I hope you all are very well aware about me. So in this particular semester, fifth semester, I'm going to teach you service marketing. Moving ahead, what we will be covering in this course. So in this particular video, I'm going to tell you how I'll teach this particular subject, what will be the course objective, what will be the course outline, or the scope of the course or the subject, which we will be covering in this particular course. So first I'll talk about objectives of the course, then course outline, then learning outcomes, and the pedagogy used to teach this particular course. Now come to objectives of the course. I already put emphasis to know the objective of any course. If you don't know what is the basic objective, why we are going to study this particular course, there is no means of any course. So I thought to tell you once again objectives of the course. As far as objectives of this particular course, that is service marketing, is concerned, here are some objectives. The very first objective: explain the unique challenges of service marketing, including the examples, elements of product, price, place, promotion, processes, physical evidence, and people as a service marketing mix. Then describe how customer relations marketing, including retention strategy, creates an environment that achieves excellence in customer service. Then design service quality measurements to build customer loyalty. As we all know that customer loyalty, one of the desired strategy in any organization. So how to build customer loyalty? That is another objective. And evaluate the effectiveness and efficiency of the customer service offerings. Whatsoever services are offered by any organization, there must be way to evaluate it and to evaluate their effectiveness as well as efficiency. So we'll look at it. Further, another objective: explain service blueprinting, the integration of new technologies, and other key issues facing today's customer service providers and service managers. Discuss the influence of multicultural marketplace, business ethics, and socially responsible marketing on service marketing. Conduct a service audit plan for a service firm. And finally, integrate course concepts into individual performance to become better customer service representative in service environment. So these are the objectives of the course, and we'll try to achieve all these objectives. Moving ahead, course outline. So the Complete course is classified by university in four different units. Here are unit-wise course content. In unit one, we will discuss introduction to service marketing. Here we'll see service meaning, definition, their nature, characteristics. Then marketing challenges of services. What are the various challenges which usually people face when they market or when they plan to market services? Growing importance of service sector in India, how service sector is growing in India, and what is the importance of such a growing sector like service sector? And finally, we'll see service marketing management process. What are the various steps which usually managers follow in the marketing of services? So these are the course content of unit one. In unit two, we will move ahead and we will look at consumer behavior in service. How consumer behavior we have in case of when they choose to consume any service. Then we will look at how to measure service quality. So measuring service quality and customer satisfaction, there are various tools available there, in managerial practice. So we will look at tools, how we can measure service quality and customer satisfaction as well. There is very popular model known as Cerviqual scale to measure service quality. So we will look at it in detail. There is gap model. There are five gap model is available. So we will look at this gap model, what are the various gaps, where it exists, and what are the various strategy where a manager can work on and bridge all these gaps. And the last topic in unit two is modes of service recovery. What are the various modes? How we can recover the failed services, right? So these are the course content in unit two. Moving ahead in unit three, we will look at the 7 P's framework for service marketing. These 7 P's framework is also known as service marketing mix. So we will look at it. What are the 7 P's? Then we will see what are the various nature, feature, behavior, characteristics of service as a product. If a manager is supposed to define a service product, so what are the various features, how they can define a service as a product? Then service process. What is the process to deliver service? As we all are very well aware about, services are purely intangible. But yes, there is certain process to deliver any service. So we'll look at it. Then service blueprinting. Once you have any idea about any service, being budding manager or being manager, you will have to prepare a blueprint of that particular service. Once you are through with the service as a product, you will have to think about pricing. So we will look at pricing of the services, wherein we'll see objectives, challenges, and approaches of pricing. One of the biggest challenge which usually people face during managing any service as a product is managing services personnel. So we will look at it, how to manage service personnel into service marketing. And last, role of customers in service delivery. So we will look at how customer play very important role as far as service delivery is concerned. Moving ahead to the fourth unit. In fourth and last unit of this course, we will see challenges of service distribution. What are the various challenges usually people face during service distribution? Service franchising, benefits and risk. Then integrated service communication mix, how to look at the communication part of integrated service. Then service marketing triangle. What is the key thing where manager or strategist supposed to look into that is known as service marketing triangle that we will discuss in unit 4. And the last topic will be managing physical evidence and service scale. How one can ensure physical evidences and how one can also ensure service scale into service marketing. So these are the course content of service marketing as a subject. Moving ahead, learning outcomes. Once we will go through with all these units, or you can say subject topic, what we will learn. So here are learning outcomes. Once you will complete this course, so you will be able to understand dynamics of marketing in business and marketing mix concept in order to achieve organizational goal. Further, you will be able to understand and analyze various key concepts of product mix and formulate pricing strategy to ensure profit for the organization. Then you will be able to develop efficient distribution channel so that in time delivery to the customer can be ensured. That is most important thing. And finally, you will be able to create an integrated marketing communication plan, which includes promotional strategies and measure of effectiveness of promotional mix. Moving ahead, that is more important. How I'm going to teach you this subject with the help of IT-enabled services. That is more important because no one can replace physical classes, but yes, the time is not favorable. So we will have to find out some alternates. So these are the pedagogy which I'm going to use to teach you this subject. A variety of learning methods will be used, which will emphasize a cooperative learning format. Will facilitate a participative learning experience through lectures, discussions, and presentations combined with practical exercise. Students will be encouraged to discuss issue of topical interest. Specific method includes conceptual base, wherein through lecture and class discussion. So video will be this means this video lecture will be lecture considered as a lecture, and we will make virtual meeting to discuss whatsoever topic we discuss in video lectures. Then we will work on analytical ability through examples, case discussions, and presentations. Then practical skills will be developed through live case based exploratory exercise, field projects, and assignments, whatsoever possible in this online era. So here pedagogy I'm going to use to teach this subject. And finally, thank you for patient listening. In case of any query related to this course, you all are free to reach me at my email ID. So you may write your query. Definitely I'll respond you once I'll look at your query. Thank you so very much. See you in next video with the basics of service marketing.